Sachin. I'm the guitar professor here at NIU. Before I talk about band, I want to mention that next concert, the final concert of the season. It's on April 5th, I believe it's Friday night. We have Bokyeong Byung from South Korea, one of the best in the world, will be here playing for us. I want to be here that day. I have my own concert that night. But we'll be here, she'll be here, and we have a good team. We'll take care of her while you're here. So please show up to that one. We are in the process of planning next season. I think we'll be quite amazing season coming up next year. So we'll provide the link and do tell the school music to publicize it. So keep an eye out for that. I hope to announce that before the summer starts, but it's always a bit tricky with the schedule and all that. So tonight we have Benjamin Verdery, my dear teacher. From Yale University. Some of you take lessons with me, some of you help me play. I think I owe this artist maestro a lot. So you see, tonight I think we're in for a treat. You see a lot of equipment here. I've seen him many times, and every time I hear a band, he's just blow me every time. Blow me away. It's an amazing show. So if you have a phone, please silence it. That would be a great thing. We have some microphones going on here, so that might pick up your phone. So please do that. So without further ado, let's welcome Benjamin Verdery.
Welcome. What a great thing to see you all here. I'm honored to be here tonight, this evening, and a huge thanks to the great Maestro Antron for inviting me. It's really an honor, and tonight I know there's a lot of music that you haven't heard, and so I'm going to talk a little bit about it. I normally never talk at the beginning of a concert, but tonight's a little different because of the program. It's like a new order for me. So I decided to call tonight's concert Guitar Stories, because all of these pieces have a real story to them. And starting with my piece, The Rain Falls Equally on All Things, I'll just say a bit about it. It's a fantasy, its form is kind of free, although there you will definitely hear two or three themes that repeat different times. It's an exploration of color and sounds on the guitar, as well as my little foray, as it were, into the world of rain. And I had, so all of these rain clouds approaching, in rain, separate drop falling, heavy water as the wind sings the rain, after the rain. all of these are not really movements, but they are definite sections, some longer than others. Like some are very influenced by where I spent a lot of time in Hawaii, like Liquid Rain. I love it when the sun is out and the rain happens. It's just the greatest. A child's first rainbow, etc. There's one missing here. Oh, I didn't check the program. The final one should say the rain falls equally on all things. That's the final section. So I'll have to talk to my manager. But it's also really a. And it's inspired, actually. The piece started out went right to a Schubert song. Schubert is one of my favorite, probably my second favorite dead white old guy composer. And I was privileged enough to play the great De Schoenemerler in this song cycle with the great Hermann Prey many years ago, and it changed my life. And so I went to this song called Nachtstück, and I said, oh, I'm going to take this progression. And so you hear that in the kind of the middle of the piece. There's a slow section where you just hear slightly more obvious harmonies. But the rhythm, the sextuplets that happen throughout are totally from the Schubert song. And so yeah, there's sort of, you have this opening introduction, and then it develops and all the different types of rain, and then the middle section, and then again return to things, and then an outro. So that's sort of how it's put together. And I will say that it is, the title is a title that came that I read in a Buddhist text, and I know there's many other texts, but it really is to say that we all share so much more than our differences, and it would be great. So the rain really does fall equally on all things, as far as I'm concerned.
Thank you. Thank you.
next piece is called Sopa, and it's written by a dear, dear friend who passed away almost 2 years ago, the great American composer Ingram Marshall. I can't say enough really about Ingram, and he was really a mentor to me and a great inspiration. And I have to tell him, because we're intimate, it's the way I met him was I was listening to the radio and I heard this piece that he wrote called Fog Tropes, which is a groundbreaking piece for tape and the original is for brass, tape and brass, I can't remember, like 8 brass players. And I remember just listening to the radio like late at night, this great show called New Sounds with John Schaefer, and I was completely mesmerized. I just stopped and said, what is that? So the next day I called my friend Jack and I said, dude, I heard this piece. This is some guy named Marshall, and it's something about fog. And he said, yeah, that's Ingram. He's a great friend of mine. He lives in New Haven. I said, what? And so I met Ingram, and I asked him, you know, would you write me a piece, you know, like on my knees? And he said, yeah, sure. He said, but if whatever I write, it's going to have to involve digital delay. This piece is in 3 movements. It's a talk. I go one into the next. The outer movements use delay. The first movement uses it pretty much in a steady rhythm, but not always. And he really likes the performer to slow the tempo down and kind of so it makes the sound you hear kind of confused. And I like to say the word mushy. And there are quotes in the first movement of J.S. Bach from his second book of the Well-Tempered, the B-flat minor prelude. And Ingram used to always say, those are the best bits in the piece, but you'll hear them. And again, all through this delay, kind of, he wants me to take retards and things, so that it distorts it. the middle movement, you'll hear a 4-bar, almost Baroque sounding progression, and then on top of that, I add voices in a kind of a looping effect to create about 8 guitars. He loved the mandolin, so there's a little tip of the hat to mandolin at the end of that. And then finally, the last movement also uses delay, and in this movement, he wants the composer, the player, to push the tempo a little faster, and it creates a really extraordinary effect, almost like galloping. So that's it. Sopa is a... I'd given Ingram a book by His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama called Healing Anger, which I think everybody should read. That's where he got the title from the book. He learned the word sopa, which is a Tibetan word for patience, which I always need more of. We're going to check our tuning.
Thank you.
such a journey playing that. So now, as Monty Python used to say, for something completely different. Back to the acoustic guitar. So this next piece is written by a great young composer, part of a great duo, excuse me, that I think played here, duo noir. Thomas Flippin is the composer. And it's called Nocturne for People Who Can't Sleep. So, Thomas wrote this as part, and every year at Yale where I teach at the Yale School of Music, I ask a composer to write a short piece as part of the audition process. And actually, I send the piece out to them with no dynamics, no articulation, just the tempo. No tempo either. And then I really get to see them be creative in a different way. Anyway, so this was the piece. But of course, a lot of the composers do have a tempo in mind, etc. So he wrote this, and I just loved it. And so if you notice, this is, you know, you think, okay, it's the first section is called 12 a.m., and then 1 p.m., and then there's a 2:15, 2:30, 2:45, and then he finally gets to 3 a.m., and that is, you know, different, like for, you know, different tempo marking, and then it's 3:30, excuse me, and 3:30, 4, and 5, and 6 are all just one measure. But so I said to him, I said, hey, what's up with 2? How come from 2 to 3 it gets like 4 different sections, you know? And it's and so he said, well, on the music, where it says 2 a.m., which it does, it says Allegro con anxiety, which, you know, he said, well, look, at 2 a.m. is really where we say like monkey mind, you know, he says, I'm thinking about what I have to do tomorrow, what I did yesterday, oh my God, you know, that I have to do all these things, and I just, that's the worst, he says, from 2 to 3. So that's why, you know, you'll know when it comes. You should, if you don't feel a little anxious, then I'm not doing my job. So it's, I just adore playing the piece. I think we can decide at the end of it if you think it depicts, you know, if it's a good one for insomnia. Meaning, you know, you're not going to want to play this if you have insomnia. And now I'm getting to be really old, and that's all anybody talks about is sleep. And, like, how do you get a better night's sleep and blah, blah, blah. So I just play pieces that will keep me up. Anyway, here's 12. We'll start with 12 a.m. And yeah, we should be tired by 6. Here we go. Thank you. guy who's having trouble getting to sleep?
Or a gal.
Or a gal. Well said. And he actually wrote it during the pandemic, and his wife pointed out to him that this poem by Rilke, which is he said inspired him sort of midway through the piece. Now, you may ask yourself, why did he move? What's wrong with being in the center of the stage? And it's a problem I have. You know, I'm in therapy about it. I just can only be in front of people in that way for a certain amount of time. I kid. So, yeah, good. No, I thought, you know, you should have a new perspective. I mean, anybody can stay there all the time. All right, here's the deal. So the last piece I've had a great time playing for you, I must say. So thanks again for showing up. I could have done this without you. I really could have. I could have sat up there and played the whole concert with nobody in the room. But it is more fun to have you here. So thank you. And I also want to say that I actually have a bunch of CDs, and I'm not charging any money for them. And we didn't put them out, but I have them here. And if you want CDs, I'll bring them out, and you just take them. If you want to give money, fine. But I'm not. I'm just giving my CDs away. That's it. So I won't get into it. But yeah. So now for the last piece, my mother used to always say on the menu, because she was an incredible cook. Every concert of mine was always the menu. What's on the menu? Not what are you playing? But anyway, so during the pandemic, when the pandemic hit, I, you know, there was this thing. Don't even start. So I didn't want to compose. I didn't want to play Bach, you know, which is a big hit of mine, guy I like. And my friend sends me this piece by Fernando Garrulli. And by the way, he has five names. It's great. I won't get into that. And I started reading it, and I was like, love this. It was just hitting some sort of spot for me. I just, oh my God. And so we have this, you know, story here. Of, you know, the title is L'Orage, which means the storm, but it's Sonata Sentimentale. And I don't know why it's in title in French, but the storm, and it's, you know, it's Nietzsche and Fellino, and, you know, each movement is a different thing. So they the introduction, of course, and then they meet, and then they kiss, and then a storm comes, and wind. Says here, wind, then hail. And, you know, then she gets really scared, and so she weeps. And then the storm comes back, and then she weeps again. And then they find a cave to hang out. And then a monster comes. And then there's the fight with the monster, and then the monster dies. And then sun comes out, a little rainbow, and they live happily ever after. And, you know, I thought, like, if life could be that simple. I mean, this is what I thought of, you know, like, yeah, we should. So I couldn't resist. It's a programmatic piece. And then I realized, like, wow, you know, Carulli is doing, I'm just standing on his shoulders. Like, the piece I played is where I'm going to sort of bookend this with my piece, Rain. Here it is. You'll hear him, you know, with thunder and rain. And I just thought, yeah, I think all of us guitarists always are standing in the back of those that came before us, whether it's Carulli in my case or the great John Dowland or any, you know, because our instrument goes back to, you know, with Vihuela in 1500s, so it's such an incredible history that actually very few people know about. So so then I thought, well, what if, you know, what if I had a friend at the Yale British Art Museum, and I said, so can you get me some, you know, lithographs and paintings? So she gave me all this stuff, and me and my friend, we curated this. So I'm not listing, I used to list the titles of the paintings. And I've got feedback from my friends, it's too much to read. So if you want to know who painted who did all the artwork, it's up on YouTube, and you can look at the video on YouTube. All right, so that's it. Thank you for coming. Do you still want to hear it after all this? Sure. Because that was, you know, a lot of intro. It's already running over time. I'm sure we're going to be charged. It's like New York, the unions. All right, so we're going to hit the lights. No lights here. Great, on the virtual motion. And a huge applause for my man, Andran. Isn't this exciting? You didn't know you were going to the movies. Now, you know, now I really, you know, on, I think I do need lights. I can't see the guitar. So, on, yeah, I'm sorry. I think we need a little light. I think it's going to be a disaster. I mean, I can see sort of with my computer. Yeah, I'm sorry about that, folks. It was exciting. A little bit of light. I should have a little lamp here. Yeah, that's perfect. That's perfect. That's all I need. All right, here we go. There he is, Garrone, from Naples.
Yes.
I want to look like him. I would beat him.
Thank you.
mind, they didn't send the one with the painter's name and dates. Sounds a little touchy. What's that doing there? How come it's the... Well, did you find it irritating to have to...
No.
You see? So maybe... All right, so we're going to change that. How do you know those are really the artists? You know something. One of the biggest influences in my life as a boy, you know, as a teenager, is somebody that still resonates today with many, many generations. And he wrote, this is my arrangement of one of his songs.